Hello guys, in this video I am going to explain about this EMP jammer. I already made a video on this EMP jammer, how to make it. Let's check it out in the links in the description. And I got many comments on that video that how to increase the efficiency, how to increase the range. I'm going to clear that doubts right now. Let's get started. Now, I will explain the mechanism of the EMP jammer using this semantic. Actually, the EMP jammer consisting of a high voltage generator and a coil. In between both that, there will be a spark gap. This spark gap will make a major role here. And here, first, we come to the operation. This high voltage generator produces the high voltage here. And one terminal of the high voltage generator is connected to the coil and another is not connected directly. It is connected with a spark gap. The spark gap means you have to leave some distance. It is open circuit actually. You have to leave some distance such that the spark from the high voltage generator will jump to the coil. Then you will see the spark here. Many of them ask that they do not getting the spark gap in the spark. So you need to add a voltage multiplier. Here, before that, you need to here you need to add the voltage multiplier. This is a voltage multiplier circuit. This is a single stage voltage multiplier. If you give the input, you will get the two multiple of input. And if you want to increase it more than that, you need to add this part here. Now you'll see the operation. When the high voltage generator generates the voltage at it's around the 400 kilovolt. You will get the 400 kilovolts of voltage here, and the voltage jumps to the spark gap, and here you can observe this spark here, and then when the spark is getting from the high voltage generator to the coil, here EMF is produced. When the spark is jumped, the EMF rises to peak voltage, that means peak, and when this spark is getting off, the EMF suddenly falls down. This EMF induces the electrons into the circuit. So if you have a circuit that consisting of the negative rails, it induces in every part of the circuit, which leads to the short circuit and the circuit will be burned. Now the answer to the next question is how to increase the strength. When the voltage increases here, your strength will also be increases. To increase the strength, you need to use this voltage multiplier with the capacitance of 1000 picofarads with 6 kilowatts and the diode with the 2CL71A with 8000 volts. You can adjust the frequency of this generator by adjusting the gap between these two terminals in the spark gap. This high voltage generator generates the high voltage and then it goes to the spark gap. If you are not getting the spark gap, you need to add the voltage multiplier here. Then it goes to the spark gap and it finally goes to the coil. This is the actual sequence of the EMP generator. If you want this part is actually a optional one. if you want to increase the efficiency, means you want to increase the destruction range, then you need to add the voltage multiplier here before this spark gap and after the high voltage generator. That's all about this tutorial. If you have any more questions, please comment in the below. I will clear there. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. You will meet again in next video.